Welcome back to my channel. Minasan, konnichiwa. Kyo watashi tachi wa nihongo no benkyo tsukatteru hon nitsuite o hanasemasu. So, basically today we will be discussing the books that I use for studying Japanese and my journey on why and how I started to study Japanese in the first place. Basically, I started to study Japanese back in 2018 on my first trip to Japan, Tokyo. Before I went to Japan, I decided that I should know some language and brush up on some language skills, on some basic vocabulary in order to help me travel around the city of Tokyo and Osaka. It was my first trip to Japan. I had no idea of any form of vocabulary or sentences, basic sentence structure of Japanese. So my first application I used to study Japanese was basically Duolingo. Duolingo is a free application you can download on your phones. I use Duolingo regularly to brush up on my vocabulary skills and my communication skills in Japanese. It helped me to study the basic kanji, the hiragana and the katakana. As we well know, Japanese is divided into three parts. Basically, you have the hiragana, the katakana and the kanji. And in order for you to start studying the language, especially reading and understanding, listening Japanese, knowing the hiragana, the katakana and the kanji is essential basically for speaking the language. Duolingo does not only give you the hiragana, the katakana, the kanji, but it applies them in context. It applies them in the context of sentences, and it applies them in the context of daily use, of speaking about buying stuff, of speaking about communication, speaking about food, travel, etc. So I think Duolingo is a great app for you guys studying Japanese, starting out with the language. My second app that I use for studying Japanese as a language is Lingodear. Lingodear is another free app. It goes through the basics of the hiragana, katakana, the basic numbers in Japanese speaking, some basic vocabulary, and at the end of all those lessons, you get to around a basic intermediate level. Another famous application, which is well known for studying both languages, and I also use in medicine myself, and I also used as a medical student in the past, is Anki. Anki is a flashcard application. It helps you to memorize stuff basically by exposure to a particular set of sentences or images or vocabularies in the long run. Therefore, your brain usually tends to memorize stuff in the long term. It's called long-term potentiation. And the use of flashcard applications, whereby you can also create your own flashcards and your own vocabulary lists, is a great way to memorize stuff, because memorization doesn't happen in the short term, but it's something that happens in the long term. It is a long-term process. Now, when it comes to the books I use for studying Japanese, the basic books I started off with is Japanese from Zero. It is a book which teaches you the basics from zero, especially the kanji. I always found difficulty when it comes to studying the kanji, and therefore using a book such as Japanese from Zero, it takes you through the basics of the most basic kanji to the more advanced intermediate kanji before you can advance to a more intermediate level, basically. The book Kanji from Zero is a great way to start off studying your Japanese. It's easily structured, it has a variety of exercise sentences which you have to fill up and complete. It also teaches you the writing system of the kanji and the various readings of that kanji, the kunyomi and the onyomi readings, and it starts off from the basics and it goes up to the more advanced pre-intermediate kanji. Another book I use for studying kanji is the 2500 kanji book. This book is a thick book. However, of course, I don't recommend to study all of the book. It's nearly impossible to memorize all the kanji. However, it's a great way for you to memorize the most common kanjis. Why? Because this book provides you with commonly used Japanese kanjis in daily life, and it also provides you with kanji which are commonly used when it comes to reading newspapers, Japanese documents, TV, etc. So this book doesn't only give you all the kanji, but it gives you the specific kanji you need to use for daily life interactions such as buying stuff from the supermarket, reading the newspaper, understanding some YouTube video, etc, etc. I think this book is better than Remembering the Kanji by Hasig, although Remembering the Kanji is a great book to help you understand and remember the kanji itself. I think that knowing the kanji in context by understanding the sentences when you are reading a kanji, therefore knowing a kanji in context helps you understand the kanji better, rather than understanding why the kanji has a particular shape or not. When we go to the book, for example, if we look at the book here, we can see that the book gives you sentences over here, and these sentences show you how to use this kanji, this particular kanjis, in context, for example. Therefore, that's why I recommend using this book rather than remembering the kanji. Moving on to a more advanced level when it comes to vocabulary and preparation for exams, I think the best books I would recommend for studying vocabulary and practicing for your N3 or N2 examinations includes the White Rabbit Publication Series books, the Mondai 500 and the Complementary Vocabulary books. The White Rabbit Publications, the same publication house which produces the book Sumatome series, has these small books which cover around 2,500 vocabularies or around 2,000 vocabularies for both the N2 and the N3 levels of Japanese. It's a great book because it not only gives you the vocabulary, but it also gives you the vocabulary in context. As you can see over here, the vocabularies are not only given to you, but they also give you the meaning and the use of the vocabulary in context. It also has a great tool. You can use a red paper over here to hide the vocabularies you are reading, and it helps you sort of fill in the blanks within the book. So it's a great way of tricking your mind into remembering the vocabularies which you might find more difficult to remember. Of course, in memorization, I think part of memorization is working out exercises, and the more exercises you manage to work out, the easier it is for you to memorize stuff. Again, accompanying the vocabulary books, we have also the Mondai books. These books cover around 500 vocabularies, grammar points and kanji, and it asks you questions with regards to the various grammar points and kanji or vocabulary you might be asked in the examination entry or N2 level intermediate Japanese. So these books are a great way of practicing your Japanese because you go to a variety of questions, and at the back of each page it basically gives you the answers. So you have the question on the front of the page, and at the back of the page you get the answer and the meaning for every option that you have. So guys, go check out these books, the Mondai 500 for the N2 or the Mondai 500 for the N3 if you're studying for the N2 or N3 level. Of course, you also have the N4 and the N5, but the N4 and the N5 is a more basic level of Japanese. Me personally, I'm moving more towards the N2 and the N3 level, and therefore I find these books extremely helpful when it comes to studying Japanese. Another series of books, as I mentioned before, include the Sumatome series. The Sumatome series, I personally don't have the physical books, I downloaded the PDFs, which you can find online for free on Google. If you search PDF Sumatome entry, you can find a variety of sources and you can just download them free online. However, I did buy a specific book, which is basically the reading comprehension over here. I think that reading Japanese is the most difficult part of the Japanese language. If you can understand the readings, then you can also understand the concepts and you can also understand the listening. Therefore, listening and reading go hand in hand when it comes to language learning, because reading is not only acquisition of vocabulary, but is also acquisition of grammar. And therefore, when it comes to reading, you also have the grammar points, the kanjis, the vocabularies. Basically, it covers everything. So it's a great way of going through all your vocabulary, grammar and kanjis within context, because when it comes to studying a language, the The context of the language is extremely important. In any language, including English, French, German, Italian, etc., when you speak about something, the context of what you mean by what you are saying creates the most important meaning for that sentence you are saying. Therefore, I recommend you guys to check out these books, the Summa Tome series. This is the N3 level, however, there is also the N2, of course, and the N1 levels. They are really great, they're not that thick compared to the Shinkansen series. They are not that thick, they're easier to understand and more easier to read before your examinations. Now, when it comes to the most advanced book for the N3 or the N2 exam that I would recommend is, of course, the Shinkansen series. This book is a heavyweight when it comes to Japanese learning. It has everything written in Japanese, including the explanations, and I think it's for the more advanced learner. It's a more serious book compared to the Summa Tome series. It goes into more details. And basically, I would use this book when you're more advanced and you're going to prep prior to the N3 examination. I personally find the N3 Shinkansen series and the N2 Shinkansen series quite a challenge, both in the reading and in the understanding of the book. It's quite complex. You might have to have quite a high level of Japanese to understand these books. However, one trick I use in order to simplify the book itself and the explanations is basically using my phone's Google camera, Google Translate application, which has a camera, and I use basically to translate the more difficult parts of the book and the explanations. One last series of books I would recommend for studying Japanese is the Try N2 or N3 series. I am currently going through the Try N2. This book is really amazing when it comes to studying Japanese because it goes through most of the grammar points, it goes through most of the reading comprehension and also the listening. It is also like a practice test for your N2 or N3 levels, and therefore I highly recommend this book in order for you to practice for your N3 or N2 examinations. So go ahead and buy this book because I think it's a great read. Thank you guys, arigato gozaimasu. Okay, see you next time. Cheers, subscribe to my channel, much appreciated, and have a good day, ciao.